Wait, wait, okay. Okay. It doesn't hurt that even its recent demise, PT was already one of the most mysterious, interesting games ever created. Everything about PT, from the bizarre concept of player teaser, playable teaser, to the prestigious manner in which it was released under the 7780S Studios Montier.
I'm like, they used this large word and stuff, and then you went to the 1778, and I was like, the Treaty of 1778. I was like, where are they going with this?
No, they used a fake studio. Like, what do they call Arthur's when they do that? Shit, I forgot. Freaking. When you use a different name, when you publish your work. Anonymous? No.
What is it? I know.
And it's on the tip of my tongue. It's when you use a different name. Alias?
Alias. Oh, yeah, well, there's alias, but I felt like we were going for something deeper than that.
I'm not going
to. I don't know. I don't have an awful lot of terminologies on my head right now.
Yeah, exactly. To the way the internet came together and continued to come together to solve its myriad riddles, would have been enough to make it an historic on its own. What? Right, would have made it historic on its own. Now, on top of it all, it is rare. You could have come up with a better ending if you tried. Okay. Rest assured, there are loads of people catching up on this week's new who, before now, hadn't heard of PT, and suddenly they are dying to play this game, and they can't. Not easily, at least, and that's sad, but at least they're now aware of it. Even if they don't know exactly what it is, they've heard of it, vaguely, and now it'll remain in their memories forever. That mysterious free PSN horror game that vanished in 2015. In a lot of ways, this is how urban legends get started. As a matter of fact, PT Apocryphy.
Okay. As a matter of fact, these people are questioning if it ever existed at all.
Has already begun. Just yesterday, a post with over 1,000 notes began circulating on Tumblr. Fucking Tumblr. Warning of... warning that this December, every single existing copy of PT will immediately stop, never to be playable ever again. Oh, shit. I see what it means. If you click on options, it gives you last update, size of the file, download status, complete, version 1.0, application starting, legible for everyone, valid period start, valid period end, 13, 12, 15. Remaining days, 220.
This name. System is clogged with random everything. Okay. I can't fit anything else into the computer.
Ultimately, this rumor turned out to be false. It began with a tweet of this image seen above from Minecraft composer C418, who noticed the, quote, remaining time, 220 days, end quote. Time listed on the copy of the game. He later retraced his tweet, explaining that PT was a PlayStation Plus exclusive in Germany, so the date listed on the screen was just his personal PSN Plus renewal date. By then, though, the damage had been done. A curious Twitter search for PT December shows countless people who are now convinced that the game will disappear from their PS4 consoles come this holiday season. This, I'm convinced, is just the beginning of what I hope will become a vibrant tradition of PT misinformation spreading throughout the internet. My friend Anthony Carbuni puts it best. I'm psyched for the urban myths about this we'll hear in 20 years. Quote, Konami destroyed the game because it scared people to death, end quote. Or, quote, Konami left because they wanted him to finish it, but he knew it would drive people mad, end quote. See, what makes spooky gaming myths so chilling is that they're all unverifiable. Polybus is scary because, according to myth, it only came to a handful of arcades. The JVK1166Z.ESP creepypasta is scary because it's a Morrowind mod that never actually existed. This lack of availability allows us to suspect our disbelief and more easily buy into the fiction. Konami has inadvertently granted PT some of that same scarcity, and in doing so, has made one of the best, scariest games in years even creepier. And look, even if it doesn't come to our generation, Polybus the way it does, PT 2014 birth and 2015 death are already two of the most significant events in gaming this century. In trying to demolish PT, Konami has actually done the opposite. It has secured PT's legacy as a monumental, scary, scarce, cool as hell part of gaming history. More on Polygon.com. Not a single comment, Shay, what? This was posted an hour ago. Why? Why did we know? Oh, they lied. They could just... This is... With this much press, they could re-release it and inflate... God damn, I hate it when that... They could... With this much press release, they could re-release the title... With inflated prices and make it killing. I don't know if you want inflated prices. If anything, keep prices low and you sell more of it. Thus, you make a better profit. That's one thing that only people... I don't know why people think that you make more money by raising price and things.
It's one of those supply and demand factors. It sometimes works.
Yes. I was saying all the time, but for a digital item like such.
It's like selling a phone app for $1 and then raising it to like $2. That works. But
well,
you never know what'll happen from that.
Because if those people who are willing to spend $1, like I, and know more than $1, like I, will only buy the thing for $1. Now, if the price was... Now, keep in mind, if that's... The one reason why... Okay. There's a thing we call price takers, Chris.
Yes.
These are people will use vending machines. What prevents me from taking a soda pop and selling it to you for $3 instead of $1?
Copyright.
For one, you are aware of the price... Oh, shit. Shit. You're aware of the price that... Of what us... Ultimately, you know what the price of a soda pop can is.
Generally.
You know that it's about $1.25.
Sometimes it's just $1.
Yes, exactly.
And that's where you get ripped off, because other vending machines are obviously employing this tactic.
But that's one thing. Other vending machines can't sell their soda any higher because they know you won't buy it or you'll go to the next guy, and they can't sell theirs any lower or they're going to lose a profit. So ultimately, they have to take the price $1, and everyone in the market has to work at that price, if not grow together.
Yeah, to some degree. Like, I think a better example of this was farmers and corn crops.
Yeah,
because I remember this being explained during economics, where they would talk about how farmers would sell their crops, right?
Yeah.
And the way you would do it normally is you'd do it at a farmer's market, so you'd have your competitors right across from you.
Exactly.
And you would always have to sell at the same price as them, or well, to break even, you know?
Yes.
Because if you didn't sell at the lowest price, you weren't going to sell because someone would underbid you. But they wouldn't push it below their own costs.
Mm-hmm.
So they would stop at their minimum. They would stop at what would break even. if you could beat them out, then you would make a profit and get lucky. But if you couldn't, you'd be tempting on losses.
Yes.
And one of the issues is that corn is, of course, perishable, so you can't just hoard it and wait until a good price comes up. And it would also be a surplus, then it would cause even more confusion in the market.
But also what prevents...
And so, like, I've heard stories about how farmers have dealt with, like, massive issues with money and stuff like that, and that's one of the reasons why subsidies exist for making this corn, because, you know, you gotta store it, and you gotta get so much of it, and it really is no profit.
But also, it's the well-informed... It's also the demand portion. You know what I mean?
Yeah, for demand example, is a thing, but...
If I'm buying corn weekly at, let's say, 75 cents per ear, and, you know, freaking, what prevents me from being, for example, what prevents me from purchasing a PlayStation 4 or buying a PlayStation 4 with PT on it? Technically speaking, I know a PlayStation 4 is only worth $400. Now, if anyone's selling a PlayStation 4 any higher than that, it better have a goddamn good reason for it, like PT. But if someone's just selling me a PlayStation 4 that's higher than freaking the average price of about $400, why the fuck am I paying? Why would I buy that? Because I myself, as a consumer, am aware of what the market price is. Not exactly that knowledgeable. Some of us may be, such as soda pop and candy, but the point is, that's what kind of limits the whole market of being in a free competition market, is they say. It doesn't really seem too free competitive. You know what I mean?
It all depends on the factors.
Like,
all right, now, Aven.
Yes.
You gotta shut up.
No.
We've been talking for so long about random stuff. I could have finished everything in 5 seconds, Aven.
Don't worry, Chris. We were talking about pressing matters. The Silent Hills.
I know.
How it affects the gaming industry. How can we increase the industry, this industry, how gaming consumers can reflect their demand or incentive for provide enough incentive for Konami to still carry through with the original project. Supply and demand, the developers have this game, the consumers, like, we want that game, developers should produce that one game for the consumers, but the consumers aren't getting it. Why? Why aren't they producing it for the consumers? There's a high demand for it. It's not like as if it was a Duke Nukem.
Yeah.
Or like Guardians. What is it? Oh, fuck. Like that one Guardian game. I forgot the name of it. I had it on the tip of my tongue. Everything's on the tip of my tongue today. But there's a game by the Shadow Colossus art director, which is Guardian something.
You know what I love about this?
We're super
inspired all of a sudden for some reason today.
For what?
To talk about random topics. And we usually don't make it through much in 3 hours, but when we only have 1 hour to actually do something, we've found ourselves trapped without time. It's very interesting. I've never expected this to be the outcome of today. But alas, Aven, I must finish these quests.
Okay, Chris.
Explain them. We must move on so we can do the special episode and update today, mind you. We still got to check out the
update. Okay, I got you. I got you.
Calm down. Chill out.
Chill the fuck out, Aven. I know you're
Do you think we got most of what we had to talk about done at least?
I'm still ranting about that, but yeah, we can move on.
All right.
So fucking PT.
It's terrible. I know. All right. So
I don't know. Like, I shit my pants over Dead Space. Dead Space 1, fucking shit. I love Pokemon.
I know. I'm disappointed, too, because it was a really good game. I don't know why. I'm still waiting on it. I don't know if I trust them to say that it's completely gone, but I am disappointed that something with such potential was shot down so far.
And the second one still had me on the edge of my seat.
Yeah.
But I felt a little bit more like a badass. Not completely badass, but I felt I could hold my own. Even
like Dead Space was good, but I wish they hadn't dropped the insanity as much as they did.
Or number two.
Throughout it. Like, well, number two was fair. It could have been stronger, though. But, like, number one had a lot of insanity in it.
Oh, yeah.
You know? And number two had a few pickup points here and there, but he came to peace with it all, and that makes sense. That's fine. It was there for the storyline. Mm-hmm. But then three came in, and it was full-on story. There was very, very little insanity. He was dealing with the environment, with the scenario he had to fix.
I felt like most of the insanity was located more within Carver.
Yeah.
And the only way you got Carver was...
He hadn't been in it before, like Isaac has, so he's more susceptible to it.
Yeah, but the only way you got it from Carver was if you actually fucking played as Carver. Even
yeah,
if you
that was painful.
Even if you got his story from Isaac, you still didn't feel it as much as you did.
Like, I don't understand why we were forced to be Isaac alone. You know, like, you could have been solo Clark. Yeah.
Carver.
Yeah, solo played, Carver.
We could have
worked
Resident
out.
Resident Evil it. You could play as both characters. Why
exactly.
can't
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, even if you felt like you were in a supportive role or something, like, story-wise, it would have been fine. I don't know.
It's not like as if they were both did the exact same crash land thing.
They were there together, basically, the entire game.
Exactly, so it shouldn't have been...
So it shouldn't be a problem. But
also,
it wouldn't have the same effects, because, you know, from Isaac's point of view, he's the main character, so he had a lot more going on. It made more sense to be connected to him than anyone else.
Also, Snow World didn't really seem too scary. I mean, like, the spaceship, yeah. I felt that shit. I felt that. I gotta watch my corners. The aged ship, that really felt like I was getting on. Felt like it was a part of the universe. I felt like, oh, this is old ass shit. This is real old. This is like getting on an old battleship. You know what I'm talking about? It felt like that. And then we went to Ice World, and it felt like a family trip down there.
What the hell?
Oh, shit.
Apparently, if you beat the game and... Oh, Jesus. My God, they each have something in them. Oh, my wand. Hey, it's gone.
Oh, shit. It's in my inventory.
I know. I didn't expect this. It's a box with a bunch of boxes in it that contained all these items.
Chris, what is this shit?
What?
Wait, whoa.
It's just random stuff.
Huh.
Yeah, you bastard.
It's infinitive.
I hope you know it'll kill you.
It's infinitive.
It would have killed you first.
It was infinitive. Ah, oh, sweet.
What infinitive? Holy crap. That's not infinitive.
Yes, it is.
Oh, you mean the bottle.
Yes.
That's interesting. I like how it still hasn't killed me. That's because it's using blood, though, from the other thing. If
What's
it
this?
Wasn't for the fact that you're actually taking down my health, it
primal.
Wouldn't kill me.
Primal.
What are you doing? Wait, no, don't start shooting stuff in here.
What? I have this. I don't know what it
does.
Yeah,
don't click that. That actually would shoot. Well, that won't shoot stuff, but it has the potential to, so don't go messing with things you don't understand. we want to keep the server existence.
It's animated, Chris. It's so animated.
We
want to
keep the system alive.
It's so animated.
We can,
So
we can check out what the update is like, and then decide whether or not we're going to destroy the planet, you know?
Why not? Hold on.
Okay, so let me finish these quests. Okay. So, here's what I had to do for, like, the bee thing. I had to get all these combs and drops and stuff. Some of these I kind of cheated my way around, like the redstone one, the stabilized drop. We were getting redstone through a better source, so there was really no point. Same with diamond combs, because we got a diamond bee, the 6% drop chance of a part that required 9 of to create a diamond, and then the diamond comb actually had a 1% chance. So it was so much better what we had. And then a bunch of these combs, like the fruity one, the golden comb, required different bees, and I've got them all stockpiled. I actually went, God, this is really quite annoying. So, like, the bees, I have them all in the chest in the house. And they filled up the entire first chest, right?
Yes.
And I'm like, I gotta put these somewhere. Oh, God. Freaking bucket. Oh, lovely.
Oh, yeah. June bugs.
Something. Why?
Yeah, that worked.
Anything. I can't get rid of this poison because I can't drink milk, apparently. I don't know why the hell.
He's lactose intolerant, Chris. He's mad for that.
Maybe it's because I have nausea. Look at all that protein. It also gave me... Yeah, it gave me nausea as well. So I think that stops me from being able to eat.
Diamond armor. Yeah.
You were like the worst person ever.
Look at these silverwood saplings. Is that a wand? Is it titanium boss silverwood wand? Yeah, why not?
I'm spawning in dead now. What the hell did you do?
I threw a lot of poison at you. Glowstone nook. What's a glowstone nook?
I have no idea.
Ah, it's glowstone. We got oblivion frames, Chris. We have oblivion drones. We have infernal princesses.
It's not letting me come back to life, you bastard.
Don't worry, Chris. You have enough lives.
No, it won't let me respawn. I don't know what you did, Aven.
I threw a bunch of potions at you. That's what I did.
I know you did, but I didn't want to deal with it, so I killed myself so that I could come back. And for some reason, I can't stay alive. Okay, there's only one more. You crashed the server. No, I don't think so. I think the server's fine.
You stepped onto one spot in which all those potions are able to spawn on you. I'm so sorry, Chris.
Okay, that might have helped. Alright, good.
Oh man, we have so many.
I'm in creative mode, so that. I can't die.
Oh, yeah. We have this 60k storage drive. Paper. Chris, we have paper respiration 3. What does that do?
What? Oh, it's just useless. It's supposed to be rip the respiration off of it and breathe underwater better. All that crap. Ola.
What's with... never mind.
So that's how I got all these combs and stuff. It was a bunch of bee research and whatnot, but I did that off camera just because I know no one wants to watch a bunch of bee research. I used the system to grind down a bunch of sand and stuff, so we were able to do the compressed sand, just storing a bunch of sand. It was a lot of it. We had 300K, I believe. Crystal clear, just smelting down some glass and stuff, which was... It was not too bad, actually. That one was pretty comfortable and fast because it didn't take all that many. Oh, yeah, I'm in creative. God, I don't even care about these items. Screw these things.
Chris, so, I got fluid storage buses.
64K,
some bitches.
You're still opening those chests? Do you want... I got four of those chests, but I deleted one of them, I think, just now.
What do you mean?
These don't have as many. Alright, so that's... We did the glass one. Pretty simple, that one. Not too bad. Pushing it, I saved up 300k wood. Well, I spawned it in because we had 6 million wood logs, so I think to myself, we kind of deserve it, because I deleted it, I think, at one point. I don't remember why. But it was just like, there's too many. Too many. And stored up a crap ton of iron and redstone, which you now have an absurd amount now that I've built the lasers. I built all those lasers legit, too. Like, I used our resources for them. So I'm surprised I was able to make as many as I did. And it's still not quite enough for what I wanted. But oh well. So, I mean, the piston one was pretty uncomfortable because you had to go through a bunch of crafting as well. Like, a lot of these last ones were huge crafting ones. But, you know, it comes with the territory, I suppose. And now the last two quests here were like the hardest and most annoying in the world. Well, actually, the storage drive one was actually not as bad as I thought it would be. Like, I built the massive 16 megabyte storage or whatever it is. And it didn't take as much as I expected. It took a lot of resources, because, but we had huge amounts of resources, so it wasn't too much of a problem. But I didn't expect we would finish it so easily. It took a crap ton of Certus quartz, but we had a lot of Certus because the last beads I'd finished were quantum, which are what are stored in here right now on the wall. So that's okay. I kind of wish they didn't produce as many different types of combs. They give you three different combs, and like two of them are completely useless. So who knows? But it wasn't so bad. So it was okay.
Chris, why would I need infinitive three if I just need infinitive?
I don't know. I don't know why we need Silk Touch X. So I don't question it. Don't question them ever again, Aven. Trust me. Now, this one was the one that gave me a real problem. Seared stone. To make seared stone, you of course have to smelt down cobblestone. And I was willing to put up with that. I've got 55 million cobblestone. I'm pretty sure I could smelt it all down. The only issue is that the smeltery at max point here can only produce 7 seared stones. And it produces it within 3 minutes. And that wouldn't be terrible if it wasn't for the fact that after you do all the math, you find out it takes exactly 1 month to produce the resources I need to finish that quest. And I couldn't sit here for a month. So I thought to myself, okay, I've got to deal with this better. And I was thinking back to the glass, because the way I made the glass is I had used double compressed glass. Single compressed glass.
Don't lie, Chris. You know you quadrupled it.
And it produced 1,000 for each glass, because each glass is a bucket worth. So it produced 8,000 glass per one of those units. Or is it 8? No, it's 9,000 glass per each one of those units. So I was able to smelt down the glass faster, and then putting it back in to the block form isn't so bad. It's just a bunch of waiting for them to filter through. So the glass one was pretty easy because of compression. However, there's not really much on the line of cobblestone compression when it comes to that. You see, if I'd used just normal cobblestone, it would take forever. So I'm thinking to myself, okay, I'll just use compression like I did last time, right? And so I tried to make some single compressed and double compressed cobblestone. And then I noticed something, that the cobblestone it gives you back, the seared stone worth, isn't as high as it should be. In fact, I noticed something really interesting. If you build the last block, you remember the block that took 43 million cobblestone, you should think to yourself, oh, if I smelt that down, I'll easily complete this quest, right? The problem is that if you smelt it down, it's exactly the same worth as one cobblestone. So it's like, I don't know who would invest their time in that to come up to that end. But that was fine with that one because that was a lot. I expected that one to fail. But with normal ones, I was expecting single and double to possibly work and get me quite a bit more for each smelting I went through. But I couldn't do it. So to deal with it, I had to come up with an ingenious plan on how to make more cobblestone available to smelt down at a time. So I thought to myself, okay, I can smelt down... Where is it? Seared stone. So I can smelt down cobblestone, that makes sense, but I can also smelt down parts that I make. So like the stone sword blade. I could smelt that down. And it occurred to me that there's an item that takes 8 stone. So I'm like, okay, I'll use 8 cobblestone and put it together with something, and I was like, okay, I'll make a bunch of stone plates. So I build a bunch of large stone plates because it's worth 8 times the cobble, so I can do it faster and cheaper. I don't know what the hell you did to this chest piece when you killed me, but it does not look pleased. I like to question how that works.
It's in the negatives.
4,000 damage. I don't know how. I don't know how it maintains it. I'm gonna come out of creative when I get. I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't because we got to update. But
maybe I should. So maybe it'll update.
So I used
9,000 deaths.
I used the plates, right? Expecting, okay, I'm gonna get a bunch of seared stuff, of seared stone out of it, right? But the issue is that apparently it can't smelt down them. And I'm like, I put in all the effort to come up with some compression strategy to keep me from spending an entire month on here waiting. Because I was looking at a month dropping down to an hour and a half worth of time by just compressing this one level. And it's just like, this would save me so much time, and I'm willing to do it, but it couldn't work because it just won't smelt down. Because apparently, the smelter can go up to 800 Celsius, but not 801 Celsius, and that's what stopped me. And I don't really know what these figures mean, because it doesn't make sense in respect to the actual,
shit.
Like...
Yeah! Try to set me on fire underwater, Chris.
You suspect fire is the part that kills you.
That should set me on fire. I was talking about death.
I don't know why. I don't care if you're on fire. Technically, you were on fire for a moment when I hit you, so I hit you again. You were technically on fire, and you died. Dumb. I win. So I had to cheat that one in, but I felt I was within just reason, just because, like, I don't know why I couldn't compress it, but if I could, it would have been done way faster. So that's about all I have to say about that. I don't know if that was a mistake or something, because it feels like it shouldn't have been that way, but whatever. But the good news is we've completed every quest, Aven. They're all done. We've done it, Aven. Where are you?
I was reading a sad story, Chris.
No, Aven. No more sadness.
What?
No more sadness. So now, Aven, I believe we...
Can I update?
...should go and do the special episode. What are you...
Oh, yeah. I agree, yeah.
So we're going to do the special episode. We're going to check out what mine looks like, what my world looks like when I did the single player. It's not nearly to the degree this one is. Let's go over this place a little bit.
I thought you were about to say nearly to the degree of this lag.
Like, this land is so much better than the one that I did, because it's just so much larger and we put so much more time into this.
Yeah.
And mine's effective, but it's never gonna be to this degree.
Never gonna be homey like this.
This place is perfect, and it's unfortunate that it'll be ending like it is, but if the update goes well, maybe we'll have one more episode or two.
Oh, isn't it?
But we'll see. We don't know. That may or may not happen. But it's okay. I'm pleased with it. You know, this was a good playthrough. It worked out fine. So I'm happy with it. Stop breaking the stuff. I want the stuff here. I want the stuff here, Aven. The stuff should not be broken. Don't break it. Fool.
Don't worry, Chris. It's for the freedom of the mobs.
Let's head back to my land.
To my land. This is your land. From California to the